I'd like you to welcome a young man, a young British activist who gave up 9 months to live in Gaza and the village of Bilin. And if you don't know, the village of Bilin in the West Bank is one of the most militant villages against the apartheid wall. And every Friday, the Israeli army is out there to attack the peaceful activists. There have been deaths, there have been injuries, but this young man is an example of the kind of support that is given to the Palestinians. I'd like you to welcome Jody McIntyre.
Five months ago, I was sitting on the beach in Gaza, watching the waves of the Mediterranean lapping onto the shore. If I was to return to Gaza today, the sea would be tinged red with the blood of the innocent civilian murderers. On the morning of Monday, May 31st, I was sitting on the front steps of my friend's house in South London when a man walked past asking for a cigarette. His name was Glenn, and he lived in a home for people with mental disabilities just a few doors down. But not even a schizophrenic would be able to think of an excuse for the crime that Israel has committed in this week. Not even a lunatic would dare to justify the slaughter of humanitarian workers as they deliver aid to a besieged population. This is the greatest tragedy Israel has ever seen. This is the final nail in the coffin. But it seems that the Israeli government are keen to prolong their farewell. So now we must double, we must triple our efforts. And I ask Mr. Netanyahu, I ask Mr. Obama, I ask our Prime Minister, Mr. David Cameron, How many more must spill their blood? How many more must sacrifice their lives? But one thing is for certain, as my brother Loki pointed out earlier, for everyone that falls, 100 will rise in their place. Will raise their voices in condemnation, and then a million more will dedicate their lives to the struggle for freedom for Palestine. Thank you very much.